Hey everyone, Jordan here from Ferret Art Studios. Today for my first YouTube video, I will be demonstrating this painting I have with me. It is done with my Liquitex acrylic paints, and it is applied to Fritzschick's canvas 16 by 20. I hope you guys enjoy.
So I've already got my first base layer on. I'm starting to work on my second layer, where I'm just kind of figuring out where most of my darks and lights are going to go. So a funny thing is, I actually never went to school for painting, but I've recently gotten into this huge craze where all I want to do is paint and I don't want to pick up my pencils at all. So yeah, I've even like really invested a lot of money into painting rather than drawing. So my painting skills aren't really all that up to par just yet, but this is one of my first paintings where I was really, really impressed with the finished product. But yeah, I actually just went to school for graphite classes. I did experiment with a few different kind of mediums that I've never tried before, glass blowing being one of them, which turned out to be my favorite class. I took one class that was a design program rather than a fine arts program, and I actually think that I found that class to be the most beneficial for my painting and drawing concepts. Besides that, like the fine arts painting class I took, I didn't feel challenged in that class. We mostly did things like where we squinted at a jumble of objects to just see the colors, and then we would have to paint just the pixelated paintings of just, yeah, these pixelated paintings of colors. I didn't find it really all that challenging, and we never really did anything with detail. We had to do paintings of people that were moving constantly, which, I mean, could be a good exercise. I mean, they kind of said that we needed to get the movement of the model in there, but I just want to focus on the hard details, which my teacher was always saying, that's what we have to get away from. We have to stop thinking about details. I have to be honest, I never looked at any of her work, just maybe because I was bored of the class or something. But she also used a lot of references of, like, abstract, so I'm kind of thinking she was more into abstract. I'll have to look into that. But yeah, back to the painting. Right here, I'm just taking one of my synthetic haired round brushes, and I'm just dabbing a orangey brown on, and then I'm taking one of my flat hog hair brushes, and I'm just kind of moving that paint around that blue ring, kind of just to make somewhat of a glaze so you can see the yellow underneath that brown. And the reason why I'm doing that is because I don't want to go too dark too fast. Maybe I can create these layers where you can see that orange underneath a darker color, so that's why I'm kind of breaking it down that way. But yeah, how I actually got into art was just by watching my dad draw when I was a little toddler. I remember this one time he was drawing a dinosaur, which I was huge into when I was little, and I would always ask him if I could color it in. I was respectful enough that I never did touch it when he told me not to, but I remember I asked him tons of times if I could color in his drawings for him, because I was so little and I never understood why he was just doing them in black and white. But now, like, as I got older, I admired the graphite medium a lot more than what I actually, I started to kind of lose track, like, thought of wanting to do colored artwork. Obviously, this is like gradually over time till now. But I remember when I started to go to junior high, whenever I really got the opportunity to paint, I never really wanted to. I more wanted to draw and do black and white artwork rather than doing paintings and all that kind of stuff. It was only just recently where I have gotten into this whole painting craze. But before then, it was mostly just graphite and experimenting with a bunch of different mediums. Like, I never really got to play with ink before, so I wanted to try ink. I never had played with clay before, and when we got an assignment where we had to make a clay object, I wanted to try it. But whenever it was like an open project where we could just kind of do whatever we wanted to, it was always just black and white graphite. So, not that I was like a prodigy or anything by, I'm not saying that by any means, I wasn't. It took a lot and a lot of practice to be able to gain these techniques that I got. But when it came to the more creative projects in school, I kind of always more excelled at those more than more of the math kind of aspect of things or any of that. I did like science in school, but not enough to really pursue anything on that frame of like any of those kind of frames of a career. I was more in my element when it came to the more creative projects, and it kind of made me feel safer, kind of wanting to pursue in a creative career rather than pushing myself to better myself at math and wanting to go and do something like a veterinary job, for example, which I did want to do at one point. But yeah, I guess I just liked creating things more than just doing paperwork in school. Back to painting, right now I'm just adding another layer to those blue dots or blue rings, darkening them up a little bit. Darkening them up quite a bit, actually. I made this color by making a lavender color and just adding it to a pre-mixed blue color that I made. And I'm just gonna skip forward a little bit to the pupil. Right there, I mixed a very dark purple color because right now I don't want to add straight black. If I add straight black, it's just gonna make everything look very flat. And it's a lot harder to lighten things up once they are dark. It is a lot easier to darken things while they are light. I'm just going through and cleaning up the edges of those tentacles. So it was in high school when I actually decided that I wanted to pursue in a art career, but I was just still a little afraid that I wasn't good enough. And I had two really good art teachers in high school that pushed me, taught me really good techniques, and has kind of gained my confidence up and helped me actually think that I was good enough to go to post-secondary schooling. It also kind of helped that I was asked to do a few commission pieces while I was in high school, and that kind of just made me think even more that people are liking what I am making, and if someone else is liking what I'm making, then other people are gonna like what I'm making. So that's what really was the final straw, and I was like, okay, people like what I create, I'm gonna go and better myself with making art and surrounding myself with the other artists that have the same motives as I do, the same motivation that I had, and just, yeah, being able to be with in a community with other artists. It was a lot of fun, and I got to see what they were doing with their art. And yeah, it was quite interesting to see what other artists were doing, what the professors were doing with their art. And yeah, it was very nice being in a community with other artists. So right now with the painting, I decide that he's looking kind of pale and that he needs his colors to shine through. So now I am taking an orangey brownie color. I'm calling it an orangey brownie color, not a brownie orangey color, because the orange is more prominent in this color. So yeah, I'm taking that and I'm adding in my darker shadows. These are the shadows that are really going to define the contrast. So yeah, I'm adding this orange in on where I want all of my shadows to be. And then if I need to, I take my hog hair brush again and I just move that paint around so it's not as hard of a line, and so it kind of gradually goes back out to that pale yellow color. So I think lighting is a very important thing to be thinking about when you're doing any kind of art, painting, drawing, ink, anything. Lighting is very, very important. And it's something that I even still need to think about a little bit more every now and then. But if you don't have the right lighting on your subject, it's not gonna really look correct. And it's one of the big steps on making your artwork more realistic. So right now I'm just taking that orange color again around the eyes, and I'm kind of going around the thorns, like this octopus in my reference picture. He has a bunch of these like little bumpy, thorny kind of like flesh on him. So I'm just kind of taking that orange color to make shadows so you can see those bumps a little bit better on his. Another thing you have to remember is when with painting, you have to know when enough is enough. If you just continuously paint on top of your paint that's not dry yet, you're just gonna start creating this muck. It won't blend properly, or it will just blend wet into wet, and it will just start mixing those colors together. So it's just a lot better if you just paint on a layer, wait for it to dry. You can even use a hair dryer to make the paint dry faster. But just wait for it to dry and then go on top of it with your next shade or highlight, and that will create a much better look. And you won't be creating as much mud on your painting. So yeah, working with paint is kind of more like working in layers. Any kind of artwork, you just work in layers. But you paint on a layer, you let it dry, and then you add on your next one. And then once everything is dry, then you don't have to worry about it lifting. So that's what I'm kind of doing here. I'm painting on my first layer, letting it dry, and then I go over with my shadow. And then that allows me to take a somewhat damp brush, like my hog hair brush, for example, and kind of rub that painting around without lifting any of that yellow paint underneath. Another thing that I was working while I, or thinking about while I was working on this painting was contrast. Contrast is such a big thing when you are doing anything in painting or drawing. It shocks the eye and makes it pop more. Like I kind of jumped forward in this painting, and I'm sorry, I don't know what happened to the video clip where I made those brown spots darker, but you can see I went a lot darker than what you've seen before. And that was just by adding layer after layer after layer and continuously just swapping between my synthetic round brush and my hog hair brush and moving that paint around to create the depth that I wanted. And right now I am adding a dark blue in to that into those rings, and then I'm taking my liner brush and actually adding a light blue, and then taking a clean brush and kind of swiping my clean brush in that ring to kind of mix wet into wet paint. So you can see the dark blue and the light blue together, not necessarily mixed together, but you can see where the light blue fades into the dark blue and where the dark blue fades into the light blue, which I thought was a kind of cool thing that I realized. If you guys want to see how I did that, maybe I'll make a video in the future and you guys just let me know in the comments. Another thing that I kind of lost in the video was adding some more of those highlights. I added a lot. You can see if you look in the tentacles around the eye, I kind of added more of a lighter color in around those edges, and it kind of crispened him up and gave him a lot more depth. But don't worry, I think I do have more footage of me adding in my highlight somewhere in here, so we'll see that. But yeah, I had it dead set in my mind that I wanted to go to art school and take a fine arts bachelor program, which I did. I went through with it for about 2 years. I had lots of fun in my glass-blowing class, like I mentioned before, but not really any of the other classes. And I kind of got into school when they started to make a lot of changes to all of their classes. Like, they canceled some out, and I didn't live near the school, so for me, it would have been very hard. I would have probably been at the school from 7 o'clock in the morning to probably 12 o'clock at night, which I know some of the kids that went to that school did, but I kind of work better when I'm at home. For the classes that I didn't have the tools at home, I definitely stayed at the school to finish. But for the most part, I like to sit at home where I can listen to music, where I can watch TV, and not have to worry about distracting anyone around me. So once they started making all these changes, I actually felt like it was more beneficial if I just quit while I was ahead financially, and I basically just started making my own class outlines by finding a bunch of artists on YouTube that I really enjoyed, which really is what inspired me to start making my own YouTube videos, was because I enjoyed watching them create what they were doing so much. I thought maybe I could build an audience where they will enjoy what I'm creating. I also think that YouTube is a great way to actually be able to connect with the people that are watching. And it's the best way to get my opinions across to my audience. And but yeah, sometimes I'll watch videos while I'm painting or drawing, or I'll even just watch a video and I'll have one of my notebooks out and I will be just jotting down notes on things that I saw the artist do in that video that I liked, or things that I noticed about their composition that I liked, and I found that to actually be more beneficial and more hands-on than actually attending attending art school, and of course this is just obviously my own opinion. Some people will do much better if they do go to art school and get the continuous practice from their classes, but for me personally, I found that I have learned more by setting up my own learning paths and whatnot, and taking on projects that I like myself. Like, if I see a video of a tutorial that I like, I will actually do the actual tutorial. I won't do videos on those ones because that's just kind of someone else's idea. I don't want to get into copyright issues or anything like that. But with doing those tutorials, I get to kind of see my progress, and I get to kind of compare it in a way to someone else's and pick up some of their tricks that they used, and even just taking tricks and using them in my own artwork. And yeah, with those, I follow the tutorials, but when it comes down to my own artwork, I want it to show my own personality and who I am. And so that is what I'm really trying to convey in my art recently. Yeah, so now that I'm out of school, it is my goal to start kind of building my portfolio back up again and my skills back up again, because I feel like I kind of didn't get enough time to be able to detail things how I wanted to, so I kind of lost patience with doing my artwork. So that is my goal now, is to build that patience back up and build my personality back into my artwork. So, you see how I wiped away that paint with that piece of paper towel? What I did is, I messed up. I painted outside of my line and I didn't like it, so I took one of my soft haired brushes, wet it down, and just basically swiped that paint off of the canvas, and then I just dabbed my paper towel onto where I swiped off that paint, and it basically just cleans it. You want to be very gentle when you do this though, because if you're too harsh on your canvas, you might start lifting up your layers, your dry layers that you've previously put on. So now I am actually going in and adding more highlights. I'm crisping up those edges and kind of just making everything a little bit more clean. And you can see as I add in more highlights and more shadows, he gets more depth, he becomes more round, he becomes more 3D like rather than 2D, and anything that is light gets pushed forward, anything that is dark gets pushed back, and I find that's really good to think about when you're trying to make your contrast stronger, is think the darker it is, the more pushed back it's going to look, the lighter it is, the more it's going to be pushed forward. Back onto the whole subject of putting my personality into my artwork, I've just recently been doing some notes, just some bubble jot notes of things that I find pleasing to the eye myself, and I found that a lot of them are like things like Victorian objects and oddities and a lot of kind of historical kind of things, like even just steampunk kind of like things. I want to incorporate those into my painting somehow in the future and be able to kind of give people more of a feeling of who I am. I know that most of my artwork will definitely revolve around wildlife. I really, really like painting living things as well. It is the more like just kind of objects that I need to start incorporating into my artwork rather than just a horse portrait or just an octopus. I want to start adding in these like little things that just kind of add more character to the final painting. And yeah. So now I'm just adding my last few highlights and my last few shadows. I'm just kind of cleaning everything up, making sure everything is what I want it to be. It's kind of when I take a step back, put my reference photo away, and think what I want to do to the painting. So yeah, that's what I'm just doing here. So I actually use black in my paintings a lot. I don't go overboard with it because if you do go overboard with black, it's just going to look flat. It's not going to have any dimension to it. But if you use it as a glaze once you have your dark on and then you use the black as a glaze, it actually really works very well, and I love using black. I know that there's artists out there that swear that they will never use black in a painting, but you'll see that I actually do use black in the pupil of this octopus's eye. I also take this reddish orange color and I just go at the top of the iris of the eye and I just kind of darken that up a bit because the top of the eye is usually darker than the bottom of the eye, so I use this reddish orange color to kind of make more depth in his eye and give it more of a 3D kind of like a 3D dimension to it rather than having it just kind of flat and not as much attention as the rest of the painting has gotten. And I use my black right at the end, so I really don't overdo that color. It is such a hard color. If you overdo it, it's just gonna look flat. So I do it at the end so I know that I'm not drawing attention to those really dark areas. And that's it for the tutorial. So I'll see you in a minute and we will wrap this up.
And there we have it. I really hope you guys liked this video. I hope you tune in for our next one. It's going to be of the red flower in the corner here. Yeah, if you guys would like to, you can head over to my website. I'm going to leave a link in the description for you. Also, I'm going to leave a link in the description for Pixabay. For those who don't know, Pixabay is a wonderful website where you can get royalty-free images from. So, yeah, you don't have to worry about any copyright issues or anything. So, yeah, that's it for this video. I'm gonna be uploading some more videos in the future. If you guys want to be notified for when those go up, hit that subscribe button. Also, I am on a few social media networks, so if you would like to, I'm gonna leave the link in the description for you guys. Yeah, besides that, you guys have a wonderful day.